Okay, next lesson 4.2, integration. Because anti-differentiation is the inverse operation of differentiation, so anti-differentiation theorems can be obtained from differentiation theorems. Thus, the following theorems can be proved from the corresponding ones for differentiation. Theorem 4.2.1. The integration of dx is equal to x plus c. Again, integration of dx is equal to x plus c. Theorem 4.2.2. The integration of a f of x dx is equal to a integration of f of x dx, where a is a constant. The theorem 4.2.2 states that to find the antiderivative of a constant times a function, find first an antiderivative of the function, then multiply it by the constant. Okay, kaya sineparate na dito, di ba, yung constant. Sineparate muna siya with the integration. Then kunin mo na integration ng function, then multiply to the given constant. Theorem 4.2.3, if f of 1 and f of 2 are defined on the same interval, then the integration of the quantity of f of 1 of x plus f of 2 of x dx is also equal to integration of f of 1 x dx plus integration of f of 2 x dx. Next is the theorem 4.2.4. If n is a rational number, so we have the integration of x raised to n dx is equals to x to the n plus 1 all over n plus 1 plus c, where n is not equal with negative 1. So the theorem 4.2.3 states that to find the antiderivative of the sum of two functions separately and then add the results. Ayan. So itong 4.2.3, kapag may sum or difference of two or more functions, ang gagawin mo lang doon, you are going to find the antiderivative of a function separately. Next, yung proof naman itong theorem 4.2.4. Let's say we have to find the derivative of the given f of x, which is x to the n plus 1 all over n plus 1. So, ang magiging derivative lang nun na yung kanyang exponent, so magiging coefficient n plus 1, then yung n plus 1 minus 1. Yun yung rule natin sa differentiation. All over n plus 1. Since n plus 1 is a constant, so ang mangyayari, cancel out na yung n plus 1, ang matitira na lang ay x to the n. Kasi yung plus 1 minus 1, 0 na to, di ba? Ito naman magiging divide. N plus 1 divide n plus 1. So matitira na lang x to the n. And that is true. Kasi dito sa ating definition, yung kanyang integrand ay x to the n. So pag kinuha yung derivative ng f of x, dapat ang maging sagot ay yung integrand. And it is checked. Okay? Okay, tingnan natin sa illustration ng ano. Applying theorem 4.2.4 for particular values of n. Let's say, find the integration of x dx. So, by the rule or by the theorem 4.2.4, gagawin mo lang doon ay x. So, the 1 plus 1, kasi di ba ang kanyang exponent ay 1. So, mag-a-add lang tayo ng 1. Then, yung kanyang denominator magiging 1 plus 1. So it will become x square over 2, or similar as 1 half x square plus arbitrary constant. So huwag niyong kakalimutan yung plus c. Laging kasama yon sa final answer ng ating integration. Plus arbitrary constant or plus c. Mapansin mo yung ginawa lang na operation ay inverse operation ng subtraction, which is addition, and inverse operation naman ng multiplication, and that is division. So, ganun lang yung ginagawa sa anti-differentiation. Next example, integration of 1 over x squared dx. So pag kinonvert natin itong 1 over x squared dx, pwede siya maging integration of x raised to the negative 2 dx. Okay? Meron tayong rule na ganyan sa law of exponent. So therefore, i-apply na natin yung theorem 4.2.4. So it will become x raised to the negative 2 plus 1. Then denominator, negative 2 plus 1. Kung ano yung ginawa mo sa exponent, yun din ang magiging denominator niya. Then i-operate na natin. So yung numerator muna magiging x to the negative 1. Kasi negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. Then yung denominator, ganun din negative 1. Or it is also written as negative 1 over x plus c. Okay? Next example, integration of x cubed dx. So by the theorem 4.2.4, so mangyayari ngayon ay x to the 3 plus 1, yung exponent, then yung denominator, 3 plus 1 pa rin. So it will gives us x to the 4 over 4 plus c. Next, integration of cube root of x dx. Okay, ang cube root of x dx, pwede natin siya i-convert into rational exponent. So magiging integration of x raised to 1/3 dx. Okay, sa conversion ng n root, convert to rational exponent. Okay? So, pwede natin i-apply yung theorem 4.2.4. Then, we have raised to x, x raised to 1/3 plus 1 yung exponent. Then, ang denominator, 1/3 plus 1 pa rin. So, sa numerator, magiging x raised to 4 over 3. 1/3 plus 1 is 4 over 3. At yung denominator, 4 over 3. Then, meron tayong rule, di ba? Sa mixed fraction. Ang 1 over 4 over 3 ay pwede siyang maging the same as 3/4. Diba? Pwede siyang maging, kasi 1 divided by 4 over 3 is also the same as 3/4. Okay? So, pwede siyang maging 3/4. Kaya ito ay pwedeng maging 3/4 x raised to 4/3 plus c. Okay, and that's it. Okay, for illustration 2, applying theorem 4.2.2 for particular values of n. So we have the integration of 2x dx. Ito yung meron ng coefficient or meron ng constant doon sa x. So separate muna natin yung constant 2, then find the integration of x dx. At ang integration ng x dx ay x raised to 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. Then multiply natin yung constant 2. So ang magiging result natin, 2x raised to 2. Kasi 1 plus 1 is 2. Then yung denominator, 2 pa rin. Mapapansin mo dito, may makakancel out na yung 2. Cancel out na yan. So matitira na lang ay x squared then plus c. Huwag kakalimutan ng constant, arbitrary constant plus c. Okay, so yun na yung ating integration ng 2x dx. Next is 4x cubed dx. Okay, so separate na natin yung constant 4, then find the integration of x cubed dx. At ang integration ng x cubed dx ay x to the 4 over 4. So meron na tayong constant 4, then makakancel out yung 4 and 4. So matitira na lang ay x to the 4 plus c. Kasi cancel out na itong dalawa. Okay? For illustration number 3, the next illustration show how theorem 4.2.2 or 4.2.1 through 4.2.4 are used to anti-differentiate. Okay. Find the integration of 4x minus 3 dx. So, dalawa na yung ginamit natin term dito. Ano? So, ang gagawin mo lang, find the integration separately. So, yung isa mo na, integration of 4x dx minus integration of 3 dx. Then, individually, so ito yung ginagawa sa theorem 4.2.3 separately. Then, yung first term, meron siyang constant na 4. So, ilabas natin yon. Then, integration of x dx minus 3 sa constant. So, ilabas natin yung 3. Then, integration ng dx. And that is theorem 4.2.2. Then, we have integration of first term, 4 times integration ng x dx is x squared over 2 plus c. Kasi meron siyang constant, di ba? So, plus c sub 1 para sa first term. Doon naman sa second term, minus 3, ang integration ng dx ay x plus constant c sub 2 kasi second term na siya. Okay? And that is theorem 4.2.4 and 4.2.1. Next, simplify natin itong 4x square over 2. Siyempre, madidivide na yung 4 over 2. Kaya magiging 2 na lang. Next, at yung second term, negative 3 times x sa negative 3x, mapansin mo yung ating dalawang constant plus distribute na yun. So, 4c sub 1 minus 3c sub 2. Dahil yun ay product with the constant. In particular, yung 4c sub 1 minus 3 C sub 2 is an arbitrary constant by definition. It may be denoted by letter C. So the result can be written as 2x square minus 3x plus arbitrary constant C. Okay, so itong buong ito, pwede na natin siyang i-write as letter the answer can be checked by finding its derivative. O, tingnan natin na. Pag kinawa natin yung derivative ng 2x square magiging 4x. Diba? So, kaya natin yung derivative ng 2x square minus 3x plus c. So, ang derivative niya ay 4x minus 3. Kasi itong plus c, automatic mawawala na siya. Diba? Kaya, pag tingnan mo, 4x minus 3, yun din yung ating integrand. Okay.